Hello and welcome to InDepth. I'm Tina Jha. Odisha has bagged the much-awaited geographical indication tag for the popular dessert, the Rasgulla. On 29 July, the Registrar of Geographical Indications issued a certificate registering the confectionery as Odisha Rasgulla, officially recognizing the product as distinctive to the state. The move comes a year after West Bengal got the GI tag for its popular Bangla Rasgulla. For several years, both states waged a bitter battle over the origin of the delicacy. West Bengal claimed the Rasgulla came from the state's Nadia district. It was appreciated as being a treasure of Bengal by Rakhal Das Adhikari in his poem Rashikata in 1896. While the state of Odisha asserted that the reference of Rasgulla was found in the late 15th century Uriya Ramayana written by Balaram Das. Now, both states have been given the GI tag for their respective variants of the sweet, recognizing two distinct varieties in taste as well as texture. Today in InDepth, we tell you what a geographical indication tag means. On what basis is the tag given? Some important products that have been officially recognized by geographical indications and some others that are in the race to get that recognition. Besides, we'll also talk about the differences between GI status and trademark. Widespread jubilation greeted the news of Odisha getting the geographical indication tag for its famed Rasgulla. The recognition came just days after the state celebrated the fifth Rasgulla Divas at the end of Lord Jagannath's Rath Yatra. In this report, let's talk about how the Odisha Rasgulla is different from the Bangla Rasgulla. Odisha's popular dessert, the Rasgulla, has received the geographical indication tag. The registration comes under Geographical Indication of Goods Registration and Protection Act 1999. GI number 612 is registered in the name of Odisha Small Industries Corporation Limited that will now enjoy all the legal and intellectual protection available for the product. The Registrar of Geographical Indications, Chennai, has also issued a certificate to OSIC that will be valid till 22nd February 2028.
That the government looks at the historical aspect, the unique placement of that produce vis-a-vis that region or that country, and whether there is a recall as far as that produce and that state, region, country is concerned. In this particular question, there was dispute between two states. Where was Rasgulla originated? And therefore, where is the recall coming from? So the GI indication has been given on various aspects. GI indication can be that at this moment, there are these two places which are very well known. Or they could say that there is certain uniqueness in the Rasgulla. So the Rasgulla of Orissa could be different from the Rasgulla of Bengal. And that itself creates a uniqueness in the produce, giving enabling two different GIs.
The laws are very clearly laid down in the Geographical Indications Act of 1999 itself. The product, if it does not have separate features, for instance, the Odisha Rasgulla, as you mentioned, and the Bangla Rasgulla, their process of production, their appearance to a certain extent, because the Odisha Rasgulla, from what I have heard and tasted of that excellent sweetmeat, is off-white in color, whereas the Bangla Rasgulla is invariably white in color. So one is appearance, the second is of course the taste in terms of food products, the third is the way it is produced.
Odisha Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik welcomed the development. His Twitter message said, "The culinary delight is loved by Oriyas across the globe." Union Petroleum and Steel Minister Dharmendra Pradhan called it the sweetest news for Odias worldwide, describing the Odisha Rasgulla as an inseparable part of the state's culture and cuisine. The minister called for a celebration with a bite of the mouth-watering delicacy. Since 2015, Odisha has been involved in a bitter battle over the origin of the delicacy with West Bengal. It had resulted in the GI tag for the Bangla Rasgulla in 2017.
The Odisha Small Industries Corporation Limited applied for the GI tag for Odisha Rasagulla together with Utkal Mishthan Vyavsay Samiti, the Association of Sweetmeat Traders, in 2018. According to the application, Odisha Rasagulla is a sweet from the state of Odisha made of cheda, that is cottage cheese, cooked in sugar syrup, which is very soft to feel, juicy and non-chewy in consistency and can be swallowed without teeth pressure. Generally, the Odisha Rasagulla is white in color and round in shape, but off-white Rasagullas in various shades are also prepared by cooking Rasagulla at 110 degrees Celsius for about 40 minutes, in which caramelization of sugar takes place, giving the off-white color. The color of the Odisha Rasagulla is very specific. But various intensely colored Rasagullas are also prepared using the principle of caramelization of sugar with specific methods of preparation. The area of production of Odisha Rasagulla has been shown in all 30 districts of the state. Historical records suggest the Odisha Rasagulla is associated with world-famous Puri Jagannath Temple. The reference to the sweet is found in the late 15th century Odia epic, the Dandi Ramayana, written by Balaram Das. As per the rituals of Niladri Bijay, Rasagulla Bhog is traditionally offered to Devi Lakshmi on behalf of Lord Jagannath. Legendary writer Fakir Mohan Senapati had also written about Rasagulla in Utkal Bhramanam, that was published way back in August 1892. Similarly, on 14 December 1893, a poem titled Bali Jatra was published in the weekly Indradhanu, written by poet Damodar Patanayak. The poem was an eyewitness account of Cuttack's famous historic fair Bali Jatra and mentioned that the sweet shops looked attractive in the presence of Rasagullas. The popularity of the confectionery can also be gauged from a travelogue written by Senapati in 1904. Noted researcher Asif Mohanty also submitted a report to the government claiming that Rasagulla has been mentioned in ancient Oriya literature and that people in the state had been relishing the sweetmeat for more than 500 years. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, geographical indication is a sign on the product that denotes the specific geographical origin and possesses qualities or a reputation that are due to that origin. There are several benefits associated with the GI status, but at the same time, it is important to understand the difference between GI and trademark.
A geographical indication or GI is a sign used on products with a specific geographical origin and possesses qualities or a reputation that are due to that origin. In order to function as a GI, a sign must identify a product as originating in a given place. In addition, the qualities, characteristics or reputation of the product should be essentially due to the place of origin. Since the qualities depend on the geographical place of production, there is a clear link between the product and its original place of production. Agricultural products typically have qualities that derive from their place of production. They are influenced by specific local factors like climate and soil. Whether a sign functions as a geographical indication is a matter of national law and consumer perception. Geographical indications may be used for a wide variety of agricultural products. However, the use of geographical indications is not limited to agricultural products. They may also highlight specific qualities of a product like specific manufacturing skills and traditions.
If there is a product, it could be an agricultural product, it could be a manufactured product, handicraft. If a product is produced in a particular geographical locality or territory or region or a country, then and it has certain distinctive and unique features, then it should be possible to have a geographical indication registered, and the producers who are registered producers of that product should get the benefit which the brand or the product has accumulated over the years for its uniqueness, for its quality and other features.
See, that product has to be produced in that area for so long that that product and that area should be very close as far as the recall of a person is concerned. So when you talk about, you know, you can buy silk sari from south, but when you talk about a Kanjipuram sari, you're actually talking about a particular area. When you're talking about petha, you can buy a petha from anywhere. These are Indian examples. But when you talk about an Agra petha, you're so closely associating that petha to Agra and vice versa, that that's the geographical indication that produce can be made anywhere else in the world or in India or wherever, but that particular area gives it its distinct identity.
The geographical indication protection is essential as it boosts exports. The prime purpose of the geographical indications is to provide a legal protection that encourages marketers to expand their business worldwide. Marketing GI products encourages secondary economic activities in the GI region that promotes regional economic development. It also helps in building a good reputation and rewards producers with incentives. The third advantage is the prevention of the misuse of a registered geographical indication. The producer has a legal right to charge anyone not belonging to the GI region trying to use their GI tag. Farmers selling products of a given region have to face less competition from fake people who sell bogus products. Lastly, the GI product gets a reputation that spreads across the world. People identify GI products with particular regions that motivates them to visit those places to access those products. This helps in the growth of the tourism industry.
The producers, original producers, or people who thought that in their region the particular product had originated and they had cultivated it and they had developed the processes of production, they felt that they needed to get an added premium on the sale of their products, and other people, though they may be producing the same product, they should not be getting that same incentive. So that was the basic philosophy behind asking for GI tagging.
There are multiple differences between geographical indication and trademark. Trademark is a sign, name, or identity of a business concern that is used to differentiate goods or services. A car is a car, but the distinction is on the basis of the manufacturer's trademark. The name signifies the place of origin of the good, and any manufacturer in the geographical location can use the GI for it. For instance, Darjeeling tea, Swiss cheese, Tirupati laddu, and so on. A GI is basically a collective protection given to manufacturers belonging to the specific location where the good first originated. On the contrary, a trademark is registered by a single entity. While only one person or manufacturer can use a trademark registered in his or her name and address, every manufacturer or producer in the same region are allowed to use the geographical indication. Unlike trademarks that can be a letter, a word, numerals, or simply a number, a geographical indication can only be a name or a symbol related to places. A trademark recognizes the stamp of human creativity or intellect. A GI identifies products on basis of its place of origin. Factors such as the topography, human work, climate, etc. of a specific geographical location determines its nature. Trademarks are governed by the Indian Trademarks Act 1999, while GIs are governed by Geographical Indications of Goods Registration and Protection Act 1999. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Time for a short break on the program. On the other side, we'll talk about some of the GI recognized products in India. Do stay with us. More than 300 articles in India, including agri products, arts and crafts, textile, as well as manufactured items, have been GI tagged. Many of the popular products like Darjeeling tea of West Bengal, Pashmina shawls of Kashmir, Kangra paintings of Himachal Pradesh, or Mysore sandal soap of Karnataka have been given the GI tag to protect their distinctive features as well as the artisans producing them. Here's a look at the GI tag products in the country.
Music.
14 products got a geographical indication tag from the government this year. They include the Kandamal Haldi from Odisha, Himachali Kala Zira, Jira Phool from Chhattisgarh, Coorg Arabica Coffee from Karnataka, Wayanad Robusta Coffee from Kerala, Araku Valley Arabica from Andhra Pradesh, and Sirsi Supari from Karnataka. It was in September 2003 that the Geographical Indications of Goods Registration and Protection Act 1999 came into force. Till date, more than 300 products have been tagged. Darjeeling tea was the first to be GI tagged in India. It got the recognition in 2004. The beverage is one of the top exported food products of the country. Kashmiri Pashmina got the GI tag in 2008, giving exclusive rights over the product to Kashmiri artisans. Handcraft shawls, stole and scarves made from the fine wool of Pashmina goat are sought after by buyers in India as well as abroad. In December 2008, Lucknow's centuries-old art of chicken curry was given the GI tag. Famous all over the world, the handicraft was introduced by Noor Jahan, wife of Mughal Emperor Jahangir. In the year 2010, Hyderabadi Haleem was awarded geographical indication status, making it the first meat product of India to get a GI certification. Hyderabadi Haleem is a stew prepared from meat, lentils and pounded wheat. In 2016, Kangra paintings received the geographical indication, giving the art and artisans protection against fake paintings. In 2017, Andhra Pradesh's famous Banganpalli mango was accorded the GI tag. In the race for GI tags among the states, Karnataka is at the top. The state has 39 GI tags, ranging from Mysore sandal soap to Mysore silk and also Udupi saris. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
What makes for the perfect breakfast for you? If you're from South India, your answer will probably be idli, dosa or idiyappam. Someone from Bihar will probably say chura dahi or sattu. For the Punjabis, it may be paratha and lassi. But in a big part of central India, a perfect breakfast consists of poha. And amidst the many plates of steaming hot poha, the Indori poha stands out. No wonder then that it is trying to get the GI tag. Along with many other products like the muslin fabric from Bengal, the Kuttiyattur mango from Kerala, the Assam tea, the knitwear from Tirupur and the Namakatti sticks from Tamil Nadu.
From being available at all hours of the day or night outside the railway station to having a kiosk selling the dish outside almost every residential colony, poha is something an Indori cannot do without. The Indori pohe is a full meal in itself. It is commonly served with sev on top, but there's also the usal pohe with the spicy gravy poured over it. Considering the popularity of the dish, snacks and sweet manufacturers in Indore have launched serious efforts to bag the geographical indication tag for four popular food items including the Indori poha. The other three are the long sev, the khatta meetha mixture and the dahi ki shikanji, which is unique to the city. The application wants recognition for the dish not because Indore is the birthplace of poha, but because the Indori poha has a separate character and taste, and this is what needs to be recognized. Similarly, efforts are on to secure the GI tag for the Kuttiyattur mango. The mango is a rare variety of sweet-smelling mangoes grown mostly in Kuttiyattur village of Kannur district in Kerala. In fact, almost every household in Kuttiyattur has at least one mango tree. The Kuttiyattur mango grows without any special care and gives lots of fruits. It is believed that it is the quality of soil at Kuttiyattur that gives these mangoes their special flavor, taste and color. The West Bengal Khadi and Village Industries Board will soon apply for the GI tag for its muslin fabric. In Bengal, there are primarily 7 districts which can be identified as major pockets of muslin fabric. These include Murshidabad, Birbhum, Nadia, Bardwan, Malda, Hooghly and Paschim Mednipur. In these 7 districts, there are around 900 to 1100 families engaged in the production of the muslin cloth. In fact, the yarns produced in these districts are the only ones with a count of 500 or more, making this cloth a high demand one in the international market, especially in Japan. The Jaderi village in Thiruvannamalai district in North Tamil Nadu is known for making namakattis for a living. The village of namakatti makers has been supplying the clay stick to Vishnu temples across the country and abroad for centuries and is now seeking a geographical indication tag for the product. From collecting the white earth from the nearby mountains to crafting the 2-inch-long final product, the process of making the namakatti is not simple. Selection of the clay rocks needs expertise, then the rocks are crushed by traditional rollers drawn by bulls. The rich content of silica in the clay gives it a white color. The clay is then put through a filtering process and stored in a tank for 20 days until it turns white before being cut into finger-shaped namakattis, which are sun-dried for 4 days. A GI tag helps in promoting any product's export and also in promoting economic prosperity of the producers. Goods and products having the GI tag are recognized for their origin, quality and reputation. That is why experts feel that a GI tag would help certain industries. One of them is the Assam tea industry. With over 2 lakh small tea growers in Assam, not everyone gets a just price for their produce. The lack of a GI tag, for instance, hampers the tea growers in competing with bigger brands who earn much higher profits on tea sourced from the region. Another industry that is excited about the prospect of earning the GI tag for their products is the knitwear manufacturers in Tirupur. They feel that a GI tag would benefit the industry intellectually and financially, just like it did for the Kanchipuram silk saris. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
So that's it from us in today's edition of In Depth. We'll be back same time tomorrow with an analysis on a different subject. You can also watch our program online on YouTube and Twitter on the link given below on your screens. You can also send your feedback and suggestions about our program. Thank you for your time.